I am Mr. True. In this video, we are going to continue our introduction of implicit differentiation, but unlike my previous video where I spent a lot of time showing you the comparisons between explicit and implicit versions or forms of differentiation, and why you want to at times prefer and do implicit differentiation, this video we're just going to do three examples, building up in difficulty as we go, so that hopefully it helps you do your homework. We have 3x cubed minus x squared times y plus y squared equals 4. So we're going to take the derivative of both sides of this equation with respect to x. That means that whenever there's an x variable, we're going to find the derivative, it's going to seem like normal. And everywhere there's a y, we have to do the chain rule. And remember that it's, well, we'll see it. Let's 3x cubed. So that's, you know, differentiating with respect to x. This is just going to be 3 times 3 is 9. X, bring the exponent down by a value of 1, we get 9x squared. Minus, now this x squared times y, that's the product of two factors. So we have to use the product rule. So that's going to be parentheses. I'm going to do a little bit less notation than I have in my past videos here. The first factor times the derivative of the second factor. So we have x squared times the derivative of y. Well, that's going to be y prime, or dy over dx. Okay? I'm doing y prime for shorthand notation. Plus, let's see, let's back that again. First derivative of the second, plus the derivative of the first, so the derivative of x squared is 2x, times the second factor of y. Plus, along with the terms here, we have y squared, so that's going to be chain rule, or general power rule, 2y, bring that power down, so 2y, exponent of 1, reduced it by 1, but now, that looks like a y prime, so I'm going to take that out of there. So that's the derivative of the outside function. Again, this is chain rule because we're doing derivative of y or derivative with respect to x. So the derivative of y over the, or derivative of y with respect to x doesn't just cancel away. That's, again, dy over dx or y prime equals, now this is a constant at the end. When you find the derivative of a constant, you get 0, of course. We're going to take the negative and distribute it through the parentheses and get 9x squared minus x squared y prime minus 2xy plus 2y times y prime equals 0. We want to get all the terms with the y primes, or dy over dx alone, everything else to the other side. So we're going to get, let's see here, negative x squared y prime plus 2y y prime. These two terms without a y prime, or dy over dx, needs to go over the other side. So we're going to add 2xy to the left and right. So plus 2xy. We're going to take this 9x squared and bring it over to the other side. So minus 9x squared. Each of these terms now both have a y prime. We want to factor that out because you can't solve for a variable and it shows up in multiple places in the equation. So we want to be able to only write y prime once. So we're going to factor that out and get y prime times negative x squared plus 2y equals 2xy minus 9x squared. Now I got y prime times something. I want to get y prime alone. So I'm going to divide both sides by this parentheses, this grouping. And we get y prime is equal to 2xy minus 9x squared all over negative x squared plus 2y. If it really bothered me, I could divide a negative 1 out of the numerator and denominator to change the order around and have my squared terms have a positive coefficient. But me personally, I'm happy with that. Okay, so let's get on to the next example right now.
Bye!
What's up? I got a sign for you. It's 3 sine 2x minus cosine 4y equals 1. Let's get this differentiated.
Implicitly.
Alright, so we got, anyway, whatever. 3, the derivative of sine is cosine, so 3 times the sine, whoops, the cosine of 2x And again, I like to highlight my angle measurements with parentheses to make sure that we understand it's not multiplication. So we have the derivative of sine is cosine, and that is the derivative of the outside function. We have a inside function of 2x, so now this is my u. Derivative of u is going to be the derivative of 2x is equal to 2. So 3 cosine 2x times 2. Yes? Yes. Minus, and I'm going to do some parentheses just to make sure that we don't mess up our signs. The derivative of cosine is negative sine. So negative sine of 4y, that now my inside function is u, or my u is 4y, so the derivative of 4y is equal to 4. And I don't know why I wrote that 1 there, because the derivative of a constant is equal to 0. Okay, so what have I forgotten? Did you catch my mistake? This is okay for the 2x, it's okay to write 2, because I'm doing the derivative with respect to x. But here, the derivative of y with respect to x does not just disappear, so I need a y prime there. You almost let me forget that. Okay, so what do we got? Let's see here. The two negatives are going to cancel out right here, so that can just be taken out and put in a plus sign. We're going to subtract 3 cosine of 2x, or actually 6. Let's just clean that up a little bit. We have 6 cosine of 2x plus 4y prime sine of 4y equals 0. We're going to subtract 6 cosine of 2x from both sides and get 4y prime sine of 4y equals negative 6 cosine of 2x. We're going to need to get y prime by itself. Well, y prime is being multiplied by 4, and it's being multiplied by the sine of 4y, so we're going to undo that multiplication with division and get y prime is equal to negative 6 cosine of 2x all over 4 sine of 4y, over 4y. Now, the 6 and the 4 will reduce. They're both even. So 6 divided by 2 is 3, and 4 divided by 2 is 2. So we get negative 3 over 2. You cannot do that reduction, though, with the 2 and the 4, because those are inside the cosine and sine function. Again, it's not just cosine times 2 times x and sine times 4 times y. It's the cosine of 2x, the sine of 4y, and thus there is no more reduction possible. I'm just making sure I didn't make another silly mistake. Got all my y primes marks in the right spot. Mr. True, let's get to that last example. Woo! For my last example, I've erased my title and given myself more room. You know what that means. It's going to take some work. We have the square root of x times y minus 2x cubed y squared equals 1. We want to find the derivative of this implicitly. And even that way, it's going to take some work. We are going to do a couple of things to make sure I don't make any careless mistakes. As I make this video, I'm going to write x, y to the 1/2. Again, I never like working with those radicals. And I want to just emphasize to you guys that when I find the derivative of my second term, there's two factors in here. Well, I could argue there's three, but that's just a constant. So I'm worried about the x cubed times y squared. When you use the product rule, you get two terms, and I want to make sure that we get the signs correct and that you have to or will be distributing that negative sign through. You could probably handle it, you know, with having the first term be a negative 2x cubed, but I like to do all the little small steps. It helps me make sure I get the right answer every time, and probably will help you make sure you don't make any sign mistakes either. So, let's walk through this. We'll take care of that negative a little bit later and distribute it through those two terms we get from the product rule. We have a power rule here. So we're going to do, and we're going to have to do the chain rule because there's a product happening inside of here. We have 1/2 times xy. This is now going to get reduced to by 1, so it's going to be negative 1/2. And we're going to have to take the derivative, and we got a lot of room and sides with this video. I can bore you as long as you'll watch, right? and show you all the steps. Derivative with respect to x of x, y. And then minus, let's go ahead and work this out here. We've got a factor in here. So we are going to take, with the product rule, we're going to do the first term times the derivative of the second term. So it's going to be first term, which is 2x cubed times the derivative of the second term. We're going to need the chain rule. Every time we use that, we get to those y values because we're differentiating with respect to x, not y. So 2y, and that gets reduced by 1, but I'm not going to write that because it looks like a prime symbol. So we're going to have 2y times the derivative of y with respect to x, or just y prime. So that's first derivative of the second, plus the derivative of the first, which is going to be 6x squared. Take the power root down, reduce the power by 1. I don't need to write like an x prime because I'm finding the derivative with respect to x. So I don't need to have that extra x prime in there. So derivative of the first times the second, so y squared equals, now we're deriving or finding the derivative of both sides with respect to x. This is a constant, so that's going to be 0. Now let's turn our attention to this product here. And at the same time, I'm going to get rid of this and write it as 1 over 2 square root of xy. This is a product again, so like it was here, first times the derivative of the second, which is going to be y prime, plus the derivative of the first, now the derivative of x is 1, we know that by now, times y. And I'm also going to take this negative and distribute it through the parentheses. So we have negative 2x cubed y, so let's go ahead and do this as well. 2 times 2 is 4. So 4x cubed y prime, negative and positive is negative, 6x squared y squared equals 0. Let's do the distribution again to get that 1 over 2 square root of xy through the first set of parentheses, and we have xy prime over 2 square root of xy plus y over 2 square root of xy minus 4x cubed y prime minus 6x squared y squared equals 0. Okay, whew. Now we need to get the terms together that have the y prime in them and everything else to the other side. So these y primes are going to stay here. I'm going to move these other two terms over with addition and subtraction. So we have xy prime over 2 square root of xy minus 4x cubed y prime. That's over 1. We're not going to find common denominators, but whatever. Let's do the negative first because that's going to be positive. So take this negative 6x squared y squared, move it over with addition. So we have positive 6x squared y. And this positive term is getting moved over with subtraction. So minus y over 2 square root of xy. Okay, well, can't solve for a rule again. If it's written multiple times, I want y prime. So I need to factor this y prime out so that I can get it written once and thus eventually get something where it's just one, you know, y prime equals everything else. So the y prime is going to come out, and we get y prime is equal to x over 2 square root of xy minus 4x cubed y equals 6x squared y minus y. Got a little sloppy with my handwriting here, didn't I? What is that? That is supposed to be a y. Minus y over 2x or square root of xy. Okay, well, I'm not done until I get y prime alone, so I need to divide both sides by all of this, and we get y prime is equal to 6x squared y minus y over 2 square root of xy all over x over 2 square root of xy minus 4x cubed y. Okay. Well, that's great. Let me make sure before I keep talking I haven't made a careless mistake anywhere. Six, seven, five. Uh-oh. Y squared y squared, and y squared. Talking and writing and thinking and sometimes is beyond my capabilities. Okay, good. Glad I caught that. Now, this is a, it's going to be a complicated fraction anyway, but we have fractions over fractions, so let's clean this up a little bit. Let's multiply the numerator and denominator by 2 square root of xy. I'm multiplying by 1, so I'm only going to make it look different, and just to clean up these denominators. So we have y prime, almost done here. 6 times 2 is 12, so we have 12 x squared y squared square root of xy minus, so many places to make a small mistake. We're multiplying by 2, this is getting again distributed. This is why you want to be very careful with your notation, your work in calculus. We have a 2 and a denominator of 2, so they're going to cancel out. And actually, this is all going to cancel out. So we have minus y all over. When we distribute here, it's the denominator is once again going to cancel out. And we have just x minus 4 and 2 is 8. X cubed y square root of xy. Before I call this a day and make sure I'm right here, 12x squared, y minus y, x minus 8. Good. Okay, so our last example is done. I hope these three help you do your homework and better finish your questions involving implicit differentiation. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework!